guys, so welcome back to my channel today, and we are doing a brand new Sims 1 video today. And so today, what I'm doing is another Throwback Thursday video, and is actually the 10-minute build challenge in the Sims 1, because last week I did a Sims 2 10-minute build challenge, and let me tell you, I stressed out the whole time, but via the comments, you guys said I did really, really great. But if you guys want to check out that video, I will put a card on screen right now, along with the video link down below in the description, if you guys want to check it out. I mean, hey, watch me be stressed out and you can see how well I did or how badly I did, but you know, that's up to you. But either way, I have my phone set for 10 minutes right now on the timer and everything all in the world, but we're gonna start in 3, 2, and 1. Let's go. Anyway, so I want you guys to tell me how your day was, but also have you played The Sims 1, because you know, we can always, like, you know, express our memories and all around excitement about The Sims and how much it changed our lives, because Lord knows it changed my life for the better. I was, like, you know, a very small child and that didn't really have that many friends, so The Sims was technically like my family and my friends, and I had a lot of fun playing, spending like 10 to 12 hours playing The Sims on my free time during like off school and the breaks and everything like that. So to be honest though, Sims 1 has to be like my all-time favorite game. And my favorite pack in The Sims 1 has to be either Hot Date or Vacation, just because one, your Sims can go on vacation, and two, your Sims can have like a lovely romantic date with their spouse. But you know, the one thing that really irks me about The Sims 1 is because there's no like eyedropper tool at all, and plus the fact that you only have 4 freaking corners. There's no 360, there's a mod out there, but I just don't want to download just because I don't trust Sims 1 mods as much. So I'd rather just trust, you know, the generic game that it is. And I think I actually jacked up this entire thing. No, 3, 2, 3, 3. Oh yeah, I did jack it up. Great, that's just lovely. But to be honest though, I'm not mad at all. So this should be fine, and then that should be good right there. Yeah, I'm just gonna have to just take this whole thing out because everything's all jacked up, and I just don't like the, I want my house to look decent, not jacked up ugly, okay? Anyway, so what was I doing again? Oh yeah, so let me know in the comments below, how was your day, but also what is your favorite, your favorite or funniest memory that you remember back then playing The Sims 1, and when did you start playing The Sims as well? Like, I'm literally asking so many questions right now, but, you know, I genuinely would love to know what your, like, your thoughts were about The Sims 1, what were your favorite memories, what were your funniest memories, and what was your most scariest memories? Because in The Sims 1, I was a very small being, I was a very small child, and, you know, every now and then, you know, I would just get a call from a random stranger that I just don't know, and they would say, oh, I'm watching you, and I'm like, no, don't say that. I'm a child. I don't want to die in my Sims game. Like, I was generally scared of The Sims 1. Like, I thought I was going to die, but luckily I did not die, but I did lose my baby back in the day, and that was not a fun time. I was like 4 years old. I was 4 years old playing The Sims 1, and let me tell you, the first time I played it, like the first like 20, like 10 to 20 minutes, I physically lost my baby. And I cried. I was actually upset about them. Like, where did my baby go? What happened? I don't understand what the frick is happening to my game. I thought it was glitched. I thought I was going to, like, I was about to throw the computer out the window and say, I am done. I can't handle Sims 1. This game is stupid. Let's play a different game. Let's play Pac-Man, which I did, but I did not throw my computer out the window because that's just legit crazy. But you know, it's in a way, I feel like, you know, I have to live, and I lived and I learned about how frustrating The Sims 1 is, but also how fun the game is as well. So, you know, it has some advantages and disadvantages as well. It just depends on how you play and what you do in the game. And about a couple months ago, I don't know if you remember or not, but I do have a, I don't want that. I do have a CC shopping video of The Sims 1, like of me CC shopping for The Sims 1. And the fact that I discovered Sims 1 custom content, like, I've always known that it was there, but never really downloaded, just because I didn't feel safe putting it on my computer at the time. But now that I know it works perfectly fine and it runs smoothly, and again, it's Sims 1 running on a Windows 10 computer, like, it's just that simple. But when playing it, I was like, whoa, how did I not discover all this new CC that I was gonna download? And so now I think I might delete the CC that I have now and end up doing like mod reviews and all around some exciting stuff that I do want to try out in the future of this channel. And you know, experiment a little bit. You know, experimenting for The Sims is always a necessary thing because you never know what will work or what will or won't work on the channel. Like I said, I gotta test the waters. And I only have like 5 minutes left on this clock and I'm already stressing out. Well, I'm not really stressing out. I'm just like rushing, taking my time. Plus, it takes literally 50, 84 years to find a wallpaper in this game. There's no search bar. There's no eyedropper tool. I'm like, great. Thanks. It just irks me a little bit that there's no eyedropper tool. Like, I feel like I'm spoiled. Like, I feel like we're actually spoiled because in The Sims 2, 3, and 4, we always had like an eyedropper tool, but later on in life in The Sims 4, we had a search bar. But in The Sims 3 and 2, technically, we had like a color wheel, but mostly The Sims 2 was more of the color wheel aspect just because, The Sims 3 had more of the color wheel because we could literally customize anything that we wanted, which is kind of great. And I don't know what floor I want. I almost choked. What do I want? I'm going to have to renovate this house anyway, just because, you know, that's what I have to do. No, I want this one. And then I want to change this right here to, this right here, but no, that one. Which one do I want? I'm so indecisive and only have 4 minutes left. Okay. I need to find a tile. And I wish like back in The Sims 1, they actually would categorize like what type of flooring this is. Like, is it like tile? Is it wood? Is it stone? Like, I want to know like what type of stuff this is, but I can never tell because the screen is so small and it's hard to find the right wallpaper and flooring. So anyway, now that I have that done, I need to put the wallpaper in the bedroom. It's a very small bedroom. It's going to be a bedroom for at least for like one sim. And that's pretty much it. I'm going to add some windows real quick. Just going to slap them all around. Oh, that's a big window. Hello, to the window, to the wall. Help me, please. What do I want? I want this right here. It looks, that is bright. Oh man, but if you guys want to check out my other Sims 1 speed builds that I've done, let me know. Like, if you want to check it out, I have the playlist linked down below. If you do want to go and check it out, because I honestly believe that I'm good at building in The Sims 1 anyway, even though I've only built like at least, I don't know, 3 houses and 1 community lot, and that's it. But overall, I feel quite happy of what I've done with The Sims 1 so far, building-wise. But gameplay-wise, not so much, because I did a Let's Play on it, and I got so stressed out that I actually quit. But, well, the Let's Play, not the channel, because that's just literally insane. But let me go ahead and hurry up and add everything that I need. So, also the one thing about The Sims 1 is that a trash compactor. It does not fit on a counter, so it has its own little designated area, which is literally insane, which I don't understand why that's a thing. It just takes up the space and it makes me want to scream out loud. But I want to add, I want this right here. I want that. I think that looks good. I'm going to turn that right here. I'm going to move this, put that right here, take this right here and doesn't want to flip. You know, that's the other thing. No auto corner pieces are here for The Sims 1. That's all you have. You can't change it. Totally fine. But also, these tables are huge. Like, who has this much? Like, my Sims are always poor. They don't have, like, the best of life. They don't have, like, all the money in the world to afford things. And plus, they can't really upgrade their house because, again, they are poor. They can't live their best lives like I want them to do. But, you know, we make do. We just make do. I don't know what I want to do. I think I just want this table right here. I'm gonna put that. Nope. I want this. I'm gonna put this right here. I think that's okay. I have like 1 minute left on the timer, but it's fine. Right here. I'm gonna end up renovating this anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. I can always just change it in the speed build portion. It's totally good. But I'm gonna put this bed right around here. Looks good. And then we get some nice little end tables. But the other thing I would also like to have in The Sims 1, but we can't do that anymore because it's literally physically impossible to add more things to The Sims 1 because it's no longer a thing. I would say, it is a thing, but you know what I mean. It's a thing, but not a thing, and it's there, but it's, you can't really update it unless you put it on Origin, which I'm pretty sure they will never do, but you know, anything could happen in The Sims 1. Am I right? So, the basic necessities that you need: a kitchen, a bedroom, You don't really need a TV, but we need a bathroom and have like, oh, okay, okay, 30 seconds left, 30 seconds left. We got this right here. We got a shower. Oh, that's a nice shower right there. Actually, no. I want this right here. No, flip. Okay, right there. I want that. I want this right here, but I want a different toilet. Yeah, I want a different toilet. So take this one out and put that one right here. And then I do need like a sink or some helps of stuff right here. Perfect. Ooh, that's in the window. Right here. 19 seconds left. I'm gonna put the walls up. Move these windows real quick. There we go. Do like that. And add another one. And that's pretty much it. I mean, I don't have any decorations, no trees. Okay, wait. Okay, 3, 2, Nope. I don't know. What was that? What the freak was that? I don't know what that was, but I'm so upset. It's a house. It's something. I mean, it's there. It's thriving. It's living its best life. But you know, we have the basic necessities, and the whole point about the 10-minute build challenge is to have the bare necessities, like the Jungle Book. So all you really need to do this challenge is a kitchen, a bedroom, and a bathroom. And you don't really technically need a living room, because you don't really need a living room to live, even though it is a living room, but you don't really need technology. You can like use a bookcase, you can read or whatever you want to do. But what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go and speed up this process and renovate this house. But let me take a before picture before I actually do that, because if I don't do that, I will literally forget. So, you know, we can, like, you know, I can do this together. We can take a picture together, which I cannot because the Sim doesn't live on here. So you know what? I will do that later in the next, whenever I can. But regardless, I'm going to go ahead and hop into the speed up portion, and I will see you guys all in the voiceover. Alrighty guys, so we're finally doing the voiceover portion of this video. And so I just want to talk about, you know, this whole entire 10-minute build challenge. But let's just say that I did pretty well for what I could do in 10 minutes with like the house for the bare necessities, like the bedroom, the kitchen, the bathroom, and kind of like the living room, but I didn't have a couch, so I ran out of time. But regardless, I did pretty well for what I could do. But the renovation part looks a whole lot better from like before, because it was a mess before. But now it's pretty, pretty great. The roof style though is not my favorite, because we technically only have like four. We have like a steep level, we have a medium one, and we have like, I don't know, like a flat, and then like straight up no roof on the house, which is kind of crazy though. But you know, it's there, it's all we had, and it's a Sims 1. And I think the reason why I took a long time to like get things ready is because we don't technically have a eyedropper tool, and we can't really copy and paste of like what that wallpaper is and search back for it. So it takes a while to find that exact wallpaper that you want, or you want to change it. So yeah, no eyedropper tool, no search bar, very limited terrain tools, very limited landscaping. It's a lot of limited stuff. And again, it is Sims 1. It is 18 years old. And so we didn't really technically have a lot of technology advancement back in the year 2000. So it's kind of understandable why the game for what it is. And by all means, it's a great game. I freaking love The Sims 1 so much that I can play it every single day and like discover new stuff that I haven't actually discovered when I was little playing it, because I don't remember that much when I was a kid playing The Sims 1, but I do remember playing it and having a very traumatic moment, like having my child be taken away from me, you know, Agnes Crunklebottom come in hand and actually yelling at me. I mean, like, hey, Agnes, what is your deal, old lady? Get your life together, go marry somebody else, and be happy for once, because every single time I see her, I want to delete her, and I'm still trying to figure out a way how to delete Sims in The Sims 1, because oh my goodness, I have this current house that I'm playing right now, and I'm not kidding. My Sim is a celebrity and has an obsessed fan. He follows me everywhere I go, the bathroom, the kitchen, when I'm on vacation, you know, some random shop in like, I don't know, some random town. I'm like, how did you get here? Where did you come from? Can I delete you? Because I am not kidding. He is creepy AF. He scares me. And so, yeah. And let's just say that The Sims 1 is very threatening in a way, because the way I get random phone calls at random times, and it's like, I'm watching you. Oh, I'm just like, death is around the corner. I'm like, excuse me, what did you just say to me? Like, did you just threaten me, Sims? Like, what do you mean? Like, I don't know why, because it's very 2000-ish, and I don't know, I wouldn't expect that those sayings to come from The Sims, but you know, I can kind of see it because, you know, Bella Goss, Mortimer, and the Grim Reaper, and maybe Agnes Krunklebottom every now and then, but you know, I would have suspected them being very rude to my Sims, because again, the Goss family, they're very rich in a way, and so is Agnes, kind of. She's very weird looking, but the Grim Reaper, he just wants your soul, and that's all he really wants, but let's be honest here. Sims 1 is nostalgically crazy in a way of, you know, random phone calls at 2 a.m., you know, setting your Sims on fire at random times when they don't know how to cook, or, you know, all around a vacation. So like I said again, this challenge is definitely not for me, but I have fun doing it, and I think I might do it again. I say that now, and I might actually do it in The Sims 4 because it's a lot easier, but let's just say that Sims 1 is a great nostalgic game to come back, like to go back to and like discover what you learn and what you haven't learned before when playing when you were, like, you first played it. And you know, you tend to have fires every 5 minutes or every like 2 seconds in the game, because I suggest that you guys actually level up your Sims cooking skill first and then have them cook, because again, they can't cook. They will literally set the entire house on fire if they cook a hamburger on the grill or on the stove or whatever. They are literally the worst cooks in the world. Like, if you have not watched my live streams of The Sims 1, every single stream I stream The Sims 1, I'm not kidding, every single time someone is starting a fire, and I'm like, yo, don't you know that you're broke? Do they not know that my Sims are broke? Because every single time, look, we cannot afford this, we cannot replace this, we have to repair it or something, because I kid you not, you die or you have to pay, and I can't pay, so my Sims just end up dead, and then I get upset, and then I have to start all over again. It's a long process, but regardless, I'm okay, everything is fine. No, it's not, my Sims always freaking die in a fire. Frick. Anyway, I'm so extra and so upset because Sims 1 is, you know, Sims 1, and it just causes me pain of my Sims dying all the time, but also getting threatening phone calls from like random strangers that they don't know and have like obsessed fans follow them everywhere. It's a lot to handle, but you know, I do it because I have fun. I do it because I like the Sims 1, but it stresses me out sometimes, but in a good way. Sometimes. But anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video right here. I really hope you guys much enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments below, as always, will you be doing this challenge for yourself, whether it's The Sims 1, 2, 3, or 4? And if you do, go ahead and tweet me on Twitter. It's just spring_sims, linked down below on Twitter. I will definitely check out your photo and your video and comment and stuff like that, because you know, hey, 10 minute build challenge, stressful AF. I would love to see everyone stress out with me. Okay. But anyway, like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you guys all in the very next video. Bye!